rests somewhere in your chest, below your collarbone, and behind your ribs. It beats about 70 times a minute, 50,000 times a day, 18 million times a lifetime. But have you ever really heard it? Not the thud of its beating, but the voice that speaks to you, the voice that knows you better than any other, the voice that knows what makes you happy, the voice that knows what makes you sad, the voice that knows. There's a place not too far away where people heard the voice and listened. It said to them, build something. Build something pure. Build something that isn't temporary or disposable. Build something to inspire all those who experience it. Build a monument. And to some, the monument was simply life. And when they were done, they realized that what they had built was not only the answer to the voice in their own hearts, but the voice in the hearts of others as well. Others who were looking for a monument to purity and authenticity, looking for things that weren't created to be something to everyone, but everything to someone, for things that finally let them speak their heart.
When I first created these decoys, I was trying to create the effect of being able to stop the deer right in their tracks, being able to have that once-in-a-lifetime shot, by being able to put features on there like real taxidermy eyes, a moving tail that blows in the wind on both sides, the illusion of being able to have a 3D effect with it only being 2 inches thick.
Everything. Life is a journey. And the voice that comes with it. The voice which we haven't yet been conditioned to ignore. And so we listen to what it tells us. We follow where it leads us. We trust it. We are children and we are happy. But somewhere between then and now, we lose touch with the voice, no matter how closely it whispers or how loud it cries. We don't hear it. Instead, our ears are tuned to other things, things like accountants, stock reports, and the 6 o'clock news. And then one day, as we're putting the forks in the dishwasher or mowing the lawn, we happen to catch a glimpse of the joy in our children's faces. And we remember. We remember what it felt like. We remember what it felt like to listen to that voice inside our heart and go with it. Suddenly, from out of nowhere, this spark of wisdom occurs. It becomes very clear. heart still speaking. All you have to do is listen.